Well, the last few days of spring have been lovely, and I've gotten out on some great bike rides. But as you can see, the weather's shifted back to a little bit more wintry conditions. Not too wintry, fortunately. The rain has been off and on, mostly off for a change. But this week is going to be wet all week, and that's kind of frustrating. So, I thought, it's been a while since I've done a computer video on my blog, so today, I'm going to do a computer video. What's going to happen today is, this here G5 has the one and only SSD that I own, and it's going to go into the Blueberry. Why, you ask? Well, because this is super loud, and like Steve Jobs, I kind of got a thing against internal cooling fans, and since this doesn't have one, but does currently have a really loud IDE hard drive, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the completely silent SSD, and I'm going to put it in the completely fanless iMac, and then I will have a wonderful, completely silent iMac running 10.4.11 Tiger. That's the plan. Alright, the first step is... Cool, there is step one done. Alright, let's do this. That's it. My drives are named Miria and Max. And if you're familiar with Robotech, then you know who they are. Just so that we don't have anything go missing, what we're going to do is we're going to transfer all of the contents of Miria onto Max, because Miria is the SSD. So that means we need carbon copy cloner. Miria to get backed up onto Max. Clone. Yeah, that's fine. Alright, now this is going to take a while. In the meantime, let's take a look at this. So loud. Oh, the G5 is ramping up. Listen to those fans. You hear that? That's really the reason why I want to switch the SSD from the G5 to the G3. Because though this may be powerful, it's too noisy. Alright, the hard drive is cloned. Now it is time to shut down the G5 and take a look inside. Video cable, keyboard, Ethernet, and finally, power. Now, open this thing up and I can show you what's inside. There we go. That right there is the updated graphics card. No longer do I have to use the stock graphics card. This thing's got 256 gigs of VRAM and its own fan, making the computer just that much louder. But up here is what we need to be paying attention to. There's the mechanical drive. There's the SSD. So what we're going to do is we're going to take these out and switch this here and take this one just completely out. Alright, this is an Apple branded Western Digital 250 gig, and this is Otherworld Computing Solid State Drive 3G, and it's inside this little hard drive bracket so that it would fit in there. But before I put the SSD into the G3, what I have to do is I have to carbon copy clone the contents of the G3 onto this thing. And of course, the reason why I'm putting the SSD into the FireWire external drive is because the G3 only has USB 1.1. All right, just listen to this silence. Ugh, do you hear that grinding? It's just terrible. That is what I'm going to be getting rid of it with this little rearrangement. So, selective source. We need the Blueberry HD to go on to Indigo, and okay, now we clone. Okay, in the meantime, what do we do with this 250 gig right here? Well, it just so happens I have another 250 gig Western Digital. This one isn't Apple branded though, but I think it would go very well inside of the G5. So why don't we go ahead and do that? So let's show you what I got on this Mac. Number of CPUs, 2, yada, yada, yada. Okay. The serial ATA bus shows 2 Western Digital drives. Very nice. I've got a GeForce 6800 Ultra display in AGP, 256 megabytes of VRAM. Very nice, especially when you consider that this here was the original graphics card that I had in there. And while it does have the ADC connector so that I could use my wonderful acrylic cinema display, which I love, 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 and am sad that I can't use it with this new graphics card, yet I know there's an adapter. It's nice to have this not in the machine anymore, and to have this in the machine. We've got the hard drive duplicated. So we can go ahead and quit that, and we can close that window, and what we'll do is we'll go ahead and shut this down. Yep, pretty sure we want to do that. Ah, soon that grinding sound will be gone forever. Alright, now it is time to crack open the G3 so that we can swap out hard drives. Bunch of tabs on here that you would have to pop out, but I broke a bunch of them, so this just pops right off. Gotta just sort of wiggle around this speaker here. Okay. Now, we'll just take our SSD and the convenient mounting bracket that it has. What's the deal? I'm supposed to stand right. There we go. Should be alright. Hey, you. You don't want to get your nose in there. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Airport card. Stick of RAM. Adapter card for the SSD that is connected to the IDE port.
and powered up. So we should be good to go. And it'll be a totally silent machine.
All right, here we go. Moment of truth. Oh, this is fantastic. It might be an SSD in here, but it's only going to get IDE speeds. But that's okay. There it is. I'm very pleased. But most of all, I'm pleased with this.
You hear that? That's right. There's no grinding of a mechanical hard drive. The only thing that you hear might be a little bit of the buzzing from the CRT.
That works wonderfully. I love it. Silent computer from 17 years ago, but silent computer. Ah. Oh, goodness. That turned out to be a little bit more labor-intensive than I anticipated. So now I'm just going to relax a bit and think about editing this video a little bit later.